story of movies usually starts with this guy, Thomas Edison. Which is ironic because he did not see moving pictures as art or entertainment. Nor did he put nail to hammer in creating the technology for moving pictures. Or is it hammer to nail? Anyway, Edison, like Walt Disney or Steve Jobs after him, had these grand ideas and hired other people to make them happen. And that credit should really go to W.K.L. Dickson, this guy right here. The one guy who actually invented the first motion picture camera. But there is one thing that these two do have in common. Neither had foreseen the possibility of combining motion pictures with screen practice, the idea of multiple people viewing one thing together. Edison was really looking for a visual component to his phonograph invention. What he intended motion pictures to be was a tool for communication. So imagine if motion pictures were invented, but the only thing that we use them for was the news.
You have man boobs.
You've got a dirty, whorish mouth, is what you have.
However, by the 1920s, Edison believed that cinema would one day replace textbooks in schools. And if you think about how tablets are used today, it's not so far-fetched a notion. So with his intention to create a visual component to go with his phonograph, it becomes clear that silent films were never meant to be that way. Color was also an element. Dyeing the celluloid strips could better convey mood or atmosphere. In Edison's early motion picture device, the kinetoscope, one person had to peep inside a box to see a 16-second short, even with accompanying earphones playing music. So Dickson and Edison make these short films in Edison's studio, the Black Mariah, a room built with a removable roof and made to rotate to follow the sun so that they could film all day. This was the world's first movie studio. But the camera inside weighs about 500 pounds and is stuck in one place, so these have to be very simple films. Films without editing or narratives. These were simple pleasures. The first element of intrigue with cinema is just the amusement of seeing an image move. Then it becomes about spectacle. Now people who live in Kansas City don't have to wait for the circus to come to town, just the newest film. And this carnival spirit is really what drives cinema up into the 20th century. It's this first decade of the 1900s that you see a transition from cinema of attractions to more sophisticated narrative-driven films. In these early days, the popular kinetoscope films involve lurid images, sideshow attractions, disturbing imagery, and the most popular sport, which also had a lure of the indecent, the boxing match. They even learned that you could split up one boxing match into multiple films so that people had to pay four times to watch one match. But by 1900, these are the types of films that people are watching. The Wonder of the Eiffel Tower at the Great Paris Exposition. This film supposedly contains the first camera tilt, showing off the height of the structure. There's an element of experiencing the dangerous as exhibited in this film, aptly titled What It Feels Like to Be Run Over, in which the camera seems to take on the audience's point of view. And already, films are using color to express emotion, such as in this short shot by Alice Guy, considered to be the first well-known female director. In this film, Grandma's Reading Glasses, you see both one of the more sophisticated shot films of its time in how it uses an imaginative perspective, but is also using the basic pleasure of looking at a cute kitten. If there's anything that's stayed the same in over 100 years of cinema, it's that people love cat videos. In fact, a lot of these early films have a lot in common with short reels or TikToks we might scroll by today. Here, an early stop-motion cartoon. Later, we'll see how the world of magicians will take the medium even farther. But here we're experimenting with what's possible with a camera, and how it can be used for great effect. By 1900, we're already seeing adaptations of literature, with an early appearance of Sherlock Holmes, horror films, and even one of the first Christmas movies. In this film, Attack on a China Mission, we see a recreation of a real incident during the Boxer Rebellion. So cinema's already starting to tell stories of the past, and will one day use these types of stories to manipulate an audience. Entering into the 20th century, film has run beyond what Edison could ever imagine. What he saw as just a tool for communication is being ripped away from him to entertain the working class, and soon the rest of the world. But he could never foresee just how dominant of an art form it will become. In the next episode, we'll see film break out of the studio and also out of the peep show box, and land where it would stay for nearly 100 years onto a projected screen.
What kind of movie is this?